Hello everyone, in this video we're going to talk about how to rationalize the numerators and denominators of radical expressions. So suppose that I give you something like this, x minus radical x minus radical y over x plus y. Okay, well let's have it radical x plus radical y. So now to get rid of the fractions in the numerator, you have to think of the conjugate of the numerator. So what will be the conjugate? As you know, if we have a form like this, radical A plus radical B, the conjugate of that will be radical A minus radical B. Okay, and the same thing for radical A minus radical B. The conjugate of that will be radical A minus minus radical B. So that will give you radical A plus radical B. Okay, so in this case, the conjugate radical X plus radical Y, the conjugate will be radical x minus radical y. So we multiply both the numerator and denominator by the conjugate, radical x minus radical y, radical x minus radical y. So as a result, we get x, and notice the middle terms, they go away using the FOIL method, right? These two guys, they interchange and they become zero because you have a minus radical y times radical x plus radical y times radical x, so they go away. And then minus y, the last term, right? Because the square root of y, if you square that, you will get just y, and the minus sign is there, right? So x minus y divided by, let's see what we get. So x radical x. X radical x minus x radical y plus y radical x minus y radical y. That gives us, well, can we combine? Well, we can try to combine the radical common terms. So radical x has the x plus y, so we can have it like this. And then radical y common term is common to the minus x minus y, right? So we can have minus x plus y, so we can combine it this way, distributing the minus to both, and then multiply that by radical y. Okay, so this is really as far as we can go if you want to combine it using this way, but you can always leave it like that as well. That is still correct. But this is how you get rid of the radicals in the numerator. Okay, you can also do the same thing in the denominator. So let's say if I give you x minus y over radical x minus radical y. How would this work? Well, the conjugate of the denominator would be radical x plus radical y, right? So you would have to multiply both the numerator and denominator by radical x plus radical y. Radical x plus radical y. And then you get, let's keep the top just for a little bit. Radical x plus radical y. And then the denominator will be x, right? Because radical x squared is x. And then the middle terms conveniently go away using the FOIL method. The inner and outer steps go away, right? They turn to zero because of the plus and the minuses. And then minus radical y plus radical y, if you multiply them, you get minus y, right? So now notice that x minus y is in the numerator and it's also in the denominator. And since the numerator x minus y is a factor that's multiplied, we can cancel it with the denominator because that's the same factor, right? So it turns to 1 times radical x plus radical y, which is simply radical x plus radical y. So that's your final answer. So as you see, we've transformed the original fraction x minus y over radical x minus radical y into simply radical x plus radical y. So this is how you essentially rationalize the numerator or the denominator when you have a question like this. Thanks so much for watching, and I'll see you in my next video.